add music, simply click the music icon on the toolbar at the top. A window should pop up. Click the Add button and select the piece that you would like. Press OK and the music should appear in the workspace. If you want to add another audio track to your playlist, just follow the steps from before. Instead of creating your own playlist, you can also add an existing one. The file should be in the .vspc format. Once you finish making your playlist, click the Done button and save. If you are editing an existing playlist, clicking the Done button will automatically save your work. If you are editing an existing playlist and do not wish to override it, click the Save As button and save as another file. To arrange music, click the music icon on the toolbar at the top. The same music window should pop up. You can set the start and end times for your piece by typing it in or using the arrows to the right or left. You can also use the play toolbar toward the bottom of the window. Make sure to select the file that you are editing. Then, choose the start and end times by using the arrows under the seek bar. The left arrow indicates the start position, and the right arrow indicates the end position. In the workspace, you can also enter in the amount of time that you would like for the audio event to fade in and out. To mix two different audio events together, use the overlap function. Enter in the time that you would like for the two pieces of music to overlap. You can also change the volume of each audio event separately. 0 indicates the audio's original volume setting. Make sure to save when finished. To remove music, you can remove each piece individually by selecting the file name and hitting the Remove button. To remove all background music, click the music icon with a red X at the top. Press the timeline icon at the top. A separate window should pop up. To move a photo, click it and then drag. The photos after it will automatically follow. The only photo that cannot be moved by simply dragging is the first one. To move its start position, click and drag the square photo icon located in the event track. If you click on a photo, a red bar will appear at the top of it. This bar indicates the length of time that the photo will remain in the video. Drag the square to stretch the bar to the desired length of time. If the bar extends past photos after it, like so, the photo will continue to be in the video even as those other photos appear. To move an audio event, simply click and drag. Gray space indicates the absence of an audio event. To extend or shorten a certain audio event, hover at its front or end and then drag it to the desired time length. To create a crossfade, drag the event on the right to overlap the event on the left. The ends of the two events should appear in a triangular shape. To adjust the length of the crossfade, hover over the tip of either audio event until a double-headed arrow appears. Then drag the edge to the desired overlap time. If musical selections are not continuous, meaning there is gray space in between, you can fade a single audio event by dragging the blue arrows at the front of the section to fade in and the end of the section to fade out. To adjust the volume of each of the audio events separately, select the blue line within and drag it up or down for desired volume. You can preview results in the timeline with the playback toolbar at the top. If you notice, the audio events are automatically looped in the timeline. To undo this function, close out of the timeline window and under the General tab in Quick Condition, select Music. This means that the video will end when the music is finished playing. Now that you have learned how to add and remove music and use the timeline function to edit both the video and audio tracks, let's take a look at an example of a final product where five different audio tracks were pieced together.